human beings,
one of the most intellectual and advanced organisms in the world. But our existence in this world is indeed a remarkable event. Our journey from prehistoric fast formed living organisms, the single cell microbes, to multicellular forms is possible only due to the combined efforts of powerful natural forces. And the most important natural forces from all of that is volcano. What is a volcano? It is a rupture in crust of earth that allows lava, volcanic ashes and gases to escape from a magma chamber. And it too possible only due to the way of formation of early earth.
...5 billion years ago, during the period of Hadean, few pieces of rocks revolved around the earth. The collision of these rocks with earth produced enormous amount of heat and also the early earth. As it formed, the earth gradually cooled down, but the heat generated got stored up in the core, and that's the battery that is responsible for keeping volcanoes alive.
Volcanoes are the power source that reshapes our earth. They possess the key to origin our life. Also act for evolutionary need that protects whole life form from getting stuck in a rut. Current, climate, life, ocean, all are dependent. And the most dramatic effect of volcano is on atmosphere.
Now, the biggest change in atmosphere that are brought by the volcanoes can be seen if we go back 700 million years, that is to the period of glaciation. During this period, the snow covered the whole of the earth. It advanced from the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere towards the equator. And this put all the early life in danger of extinction. But a breakthrough happened in this period. The earth's molten core burst out its lava through volcanoes, and with it gave the warmth that melted the ice coverage. This event took place at a global scale. It is not only the warmth that made the earth escape from its cold cover, it is mainly the gas that erupted along with lava that impacted a lot. And that gas is carbon dioxide. What's so special about this gas? This gas is a greenhouse gas. It prevents the sun's infrared radiation from escaping our atmosphere by reflecting the infrared radiation back towards earth, and thus increases the temperature of the surface by storing more and more heat within the atmosphere, in turn relieved to the earth from the long-lasting snowball planet, which ended around 630 million years ago.
This event also marked the edge of evolutionary leap. For first time, the multicellular life forms can be seen to come into existence. The rule of asteroid lights that continued for around 200 million years had come to an end. Now a new type of complex multicellular life come into existence along with asteroid lights, and this can be seen from Edgarian fossils in Dolomite. Temperature swung from minus 50 degrees Celsius to plus 50 degrees Celsius. This event introduced many more poisonous and toxic gases into atmosphere that got dispersed, and this event served as a nutrition and for the new life forms that are yet to come. We can see trees use CO2 as their nutrients, while many more bacteria use other gases as their nutrients, which comes to them in a solution from after moxing with water or via any in other indirect process.
It is the volcano that constantly put greenhouse gas into atmosphere that is required to maintain suitable temperature so as to support the whole complex life system. Due to this gas, atmosphere heat up, and this heat energy drives all the atmospheric current worldwide. Without this, westerly, easterly trade wind would not be there, and hence no atmospheric circulation would have happened. For this, whole climate pattern would have changed. No rain, hence no life would have existed.
Due to this circulation, exchange of cold and warm air takes place between equator and poles, and this helps in keeping the Earth's surface temperature at equilibrium. Unless poles would have been very very cold and equatorial region very cold, and warm air current that flow from equator to pole flows over land and ocean surface, and through this it transfers some of its heat to the ocean, which causes the surface ocean current, and the one of example of it is a Gulf Stream.
warm air, the air current that flows over ocean. Due to the drag force, it forces the ocean surface to move along with their course and hence create the surface ocean current, which is very important in maintaining the link for exchange of hot water and cold water. And do you know, this conveys the most important belt that is known as the ocean conveyor belt, which is highly responsible for heat exchange that keeps the polar and equatorial region in equilibrium. And mainly, it is responsible for supply of food and nutrients to sea creatures. And do you know that disruption of this belt can cause a major catastrophe and hence may lead to mass extinction. Indirectly, volcano can be considered as the source of powerhouse that drives all these processes in atmosphere and hence in ocean. Volcanoes and life forms a partnership that keeps our planet habitable and hence provide ground for evolution. All this greatness of volcano, there are some other effects that impose harmful effects over humankind and all other beings. Volcanoes, while erupt, it brings us and many toxic gases like sulfur dioxide, carbon dioxide, hydrogen chloride, hydrogen fluoride, etc. along with it. And these are the components that hamper the climate health until they settle down. On volcanic eruption, ash cloud erupts and rises above to reach the tropopause and even stratosphere. There they partially block the incoming sunlight and hence creates shade, which further cools the area under it. And the lice particles, some of which are injected into the stratosphere, remain there for months and continue their blocking of light. On the other hand, sulfur dioxide and carbon dioxide, being acidic in nature, dissolves in rainwater and it causes acid rain that kills many more livestock and damages crops. One more dramatic work done by sulfur dioxide is formation of sulfate aerosol in stratosphere. Sulfate aerosols are formed by mixing of sulfur dioxide with water vapor. These aerosols make a haze of tiny droplets that reflects incoming solar rays, causing cooling of our surface. And moreover, unlike ash clouds, it can stay up to 3 years in stratosphere, and atmospheric current during this time period distribute the aerosols globally, causing significant cooling worldwide.
Once a great example of dangerous volcanic eruptions that choked the early civilizations of human beings to death is the eruption of Mount Vesuvius, located in southern Italy. Its history makes it a remarkable place, as on the morning of August 27th AD, a massive eruption of Mount Vesuvius doomed the city of Pompeii and Herculaneum by submerging them under layers of volcanic materials and mud, and hence killing around 16,000 people. They turned into a night, and a layer of volcanic ash covered the whole city of Pompeii. And on the very next day, a thick layer of toxic cloud of gas descended on Pompeii, killing the survivors. But on the other end, these eruptions very much rich in minerals, which along with time settled down and created the massive volcanic plains. These volcanic plains were very much fertile and hence provided the best land for agricultural purposes, and hence led to establishment of new civilization. The destruction of the old civilization by these volcanoes paved the path for the formation of new civilizations. One such recent civilization located at the foothold of the Mount Vesuvius is the city of Naples in southern Italy.
Now, we'll show one of the most beautiful spot on our earth, which is known for its super active volcanic activity, the Yellowstone National Park. Yellowstone National Park has experienced all the volcanic action and their reaction during its existence. It is known for its ongoing thermal geyser, hot spring, steam explosion and earthquake. Yellowstone National Park sits on a large reservoir of partially molten rock called magma. Within past 2.1 million years, Yellowstone National Park has experienced three exceedingly large volcanic eruptions. Each of these events, an enormous amount of magma erupted as a mixture of red hot pumice, volcanic ash, and many gas that spread as pyroclastic. Rapid withdrawal of such large volume of magma from surface caused the ground to collapse, swallowing overlying mountain and creating broad cauldron, say volcanic depression called calderas. And three such events produced three such calderas. First one occurred 2.1 million years called Huckleberry Ridge Trough, and second one around 1.3 million years called Henry Ford Caldera, and third one around 640,000 years called Yellowstone Caldera.
Each caldera forming eruption occurred when large volume of magma accumulated at shallow levels in earth crust, that means 5 km below the surface, and this highly viscous magma charged with dissolved gas then moves upward, stressing upon earth crust to break open and discharge earth cakes within a year. In an average, 1000 to 3000 earth cakes occurs in Yellowstone National Park. With these cakes, cracks and faults gradually develop and widen up as the pressure decreases. As magma along with gas near crust expand and corrupts with violent explosion. Eruption of rhyolite have been responsible for forming many of world caldera, and these eruption results in thick as deposit all over the park surrounding area in us. Injection or huge volume of volcanic gas drastically affect of global climate. Volcanoes form a very important parts of global system that drives whole natural process globally by virtue and its heat content in it. And without this, we would not be here and neither you.
Guys,
hope you liked the video. Please like, share and comment. Thank you.